I want to shift gears just a little bit to how you are pursuing what you are calling predictive sustainment mm-hmm. and precision logistics. So talk more about what those two things mean mm-hmm. and just some of the efforts you have in the works in regards to both of those, you know, how you're going to establish those capabilities.
Okay. In general, they're both data-informed platforms. On the predictive side, think of that more at the strategic level where we're sitting right now. That's going to inform me, Transcom, and other big material suppliers within the Joint Strategic Support where we're sitting right here. At the precision level, that's at the tactical level. That means I got to get the right equipment, the right supplies, because they only have so much lift at that level. Almost like a precision round. I got to be held accountable to get it just right. It's got to land in the right place. If it's off by a little, then it's got consequences.
Okay. So can you talk a little bit how you might be working that into, say, exercises to teach you more about predictive sustainment and how that feeds back into your precision logistics that help you make decisions on what you need logistically, for instance?
So what we're going to do this summer is have a seminar with all the senior material suppliers, myself, Air Force, DLA, Transcom, and we're going to put it in a warfighting context. And we're going to look at the first 30 days of operation of that space. Because you can imagine, there's a lot of pieces moving the first 30 days. If you got all the services trying to get to an AR. So we're going to take that and desync it, and that's going to give us an opportunity to do some experimentation and put it in the form of a warfighting exercise.
Okay. All right. Somewhat related, when you're talking about logistics and, you know, how you're dealing with moving things from, you know, fort to port mm-hmm. to foxhole. We talked a little bit about this before, but in Ukraine, you are using a system that is helping you track how weapons are used in the battlefield, mm-hmm. you know, how they're breaking down, when they're breaking down, how much you're using in terms of parts. I mean, it seems fascinating that you're able to kind of track things to that fidelity. So what are you learning from this system in Ukraine that is feeding into, you know, how you think about things when it comes to precision logistics, for instance?
Well, Ukraine gave us the opportunity to build a platform to really get at precision and predictive logistics. And so it's called the Army Materiel Command Predictive Analysis Suite. Within that suite, most of it is classified, but we can see things real time. And it's given us the ability to get left of parts, left of equipment, and probably more importantly, left of munitions that are going to be needed to sustain this fight. So again, we're moving out, we're taking that platform, and we'll continue to build on that platform so that we can get to true predictive and precision sustainment in the future.